I'm here once again with returning guest Lauren Davidson.
Hi, how are you?
I'm very good. It's excellent to see you.
So good to see you too.
It's been about a year.
Almost a year, yeah.
What has been going on for you?
Lots of shows and lots of new music, which is why we're here. I released an EP after I saw you in the fall, and then I've just released a single, which hopefully will be the first step to new music in this new year.
Live, laugh, love.
That's it.
And you said that's the first step for music in the new year for you. It's the first song that you've put out this year.
It is the first song we put out this year, and it's definitely not the last.
and is Live, Laugh, Love, is that like a three-step plan? Is that a guide?
Live, laugh. It's actually live, it's laugh, love, and then leave. There's like a little spin on it. That good old country spin.
What is that song about?
It's basically about a girl who has been done wrong by a guy, and she's getting her revenge. So she's going out and she's drinking. She's going to live, laugh, love, and then she's going to be like, bye, I'm out of here.
I mean,
that's it in a nutshell.
Did she pay or anything?
Did she pay?
Well, is this like a dine and dash situation?
No, she's
ghosted.
She's upset that somebody did her wrong, that her dude did her wrong. So she's getting revenge by like having fun with other guys and partying and then ditching him in the morning. Like she's not going to be there anymore.
Okay,
she's out of here.
What if he had good intentions? I'm going to say I don't think he did.
I don't think he had good intentions.
Is this a real life person or thing?
Actually, when I wrote this song, I wrote this with a buddy of mine, and he came up with the idea, but I somehow like related to it and kind of put a little bit of myself into it, even though the story itself that we are creating in the song is not true word for word beginning to end.
Yeah, okay.
But so it's definitely not relatable.
It's not explicitly like a detail of an event that went down.
Not like that, no.
Have you ever dined and dashed?
I've never dined and dashed. But I have told
you. We can do that. We can do
you
that.
You want to go? Go down.
Let's go out to dinner.
Go eat and then see you bye.
Yeah, because I'm definitely not going to pay. I'm doing this for college
now.
Credit. And I'm not in college. So
there
Yeah, I'm not even getting the student loan refunds. It's rough.
That's awkward.
Okay, so Live, Laugh, Love. And then you played another song for us currently unreleased.
Yes, so that is going to be hopefully my next single called Soaking Up Every Second.
Is that also about revenge?
No, that's about enjoying life in the moment and soaking up all the good times. That actually is very relatable, though. That song specifically was what I was feeling when I wrote it, which is kind of the idea that we wish time away and we're always wishing like, oh, I wish Tuesday would come around or Friday would come around, or I wish it were June or I wish it were August. And it's just that idea of like taking a breath and enjoying where you are right here in your own shoes and just being like soaking in the moment.
What if your shoes are very wet?
I hope.
And you're just soaking.
My shoes are not wet right now.
My shoes are just always just wet. It's
that
like,
sounds like a personal problem. You need to go get that checked out.
I'll get it checked out, but it's all the walking and it makes you squishy sounds every time I step.
Actually, that's like my last song, Pouring Rain.
Right. It was about soaking
about your wet shoes.
Yeah, I'm glad I've influenced your music like
Thank you so much. I really appreciate that, Brent.
So, you're living in New York.
Yes.
From Jersey. Shout out Jersey, my homeland. But you're back and forth to Nashville.
Yes, I am.
What's up with that?
No, basically it was like, why haven't you been to Nashville yet? And I was like, I don't know. And I had a lot of friends down there. So we went down to just kind of see what it was like and fell in love with the city. Plus country music being there. A lot of people I write with are there. A lot of people I play shows with are there. So we just been going back and forth a little bit to write and to play shows and to keep a foot in, you know, the country music community down there. At the same as here, though, which is why we do the back and forth.
If you like Nashville so much, why don't you marry it? No, why aren't you based there?
No, I get that question a lot. Well, I'm from here. I've lived in New York for a while now, and I grew up in New Jersey. I was born in Brooklyn, so my whole family is here too. And also, I'm a big fish in a small pond here, so I'm kind of just riding that wave. I get opportunities here to open for people and to network that I wouldn't get if I was down there. So I kind of like being here, taking those opportunities, growing my brand, growing my fan base, getting music out, and then kind of doing the back and forth so that I can keep going there, but keep my foot here as well.
If you could headline a major festival and you were creating the lineup, who would be your top three opening acts?
Like who would open
for you?
For me?
Yep.
Well, I mean, they're all way more successful than I am, though. I'm not worthy.
This is a hypothetical.
Grace Potter, Stevie Nicks, and Maren Morris.
Maren Morris, we interviewed her husband.
Did you? I love Ryan Hurd. He's awesome.
Maren.
Hey, Maren. And Ryan. I would take Ryan Hurd, too. He can open for me.
If we got...
Hi, Ryan.
If we got a collaboration...
That would be amazing.
Stirred up for you?
Oh, my God.
Would that be something you would pay me for?
I mean, you know, we'll talk about it later. Shh, hush, hush.
Over that dine and dash dinner we're going to? Yeah,
we'll I mean, you really need that money, then. Dude, you know?
I'm telling you, times are tough. People aren't reading anymore, either, you know?
True.
It's like...
You have to like throw it in their face in a video.
Well, that's exactly what we're doing.
How you doing?
Put on your 3D glasses now. Pop right.
Right.
So are you putting these songs together to be part of a new project? Yeah. Or do you think you're going to kind of just put stuff out?
We don't have a concrete plan, but I think the goal is to put out that song that you heard, Soaking Up Every Second, as another single, and then have both of these two songs be part of a larger project before the year is over.
Do you feel that all of the songs that you're writing right now are going to have sort of, they all seem to have a positive message and positive vibe?
I'm not sure if they all are going to be completely positive, but they're all going to be a piece of me and like another layer of me that we haven't seen before. Like there definitely is going to be something that's going to make them feel cohesive. I'm not just going to like take a bunch of songs and throw them together. Be like, here you go. I definitely want it to have a feel and a theme and some sort of cohesiveness for sure.
What do you think it's saying about you? Are you a positive person?
Sometimes I'm positive. Sometimes I'm not. I think we all have our moods and, you know, that's okay.
It's not okay.
Yes, it is. It is okay. It is okay, Brent, I promise.
I honestly really needed to hear that.
I'm glad that I could be that person for
freaking
you.
Freaking out because everybody with the things and they're always...
It's okay, buddy.
It's a lot of pressure.
You got this.
Thank you.
You got to soak up every second, dude.
I need to learn to just live, laugh, and love.
There you go.
And then leave.
Bye-bye.
Without paying. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in to Pop Dust Presents.
Hell yeah.
This has been Lauren Davidson.
That's me.
Check out her new single, Live, Laugh, Love.